legend is on, burn the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Gitche Gumee. The lake, it is said, never gives up for dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. The load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. The good ship and true was about to be true when the gales of November came hurry. The ship was a pride of the American sun, coming back from somewhere in Wisconsin. As the big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and good captain well seasoned, including some terms with a couple of steel firms when they left fully loaded for Clayton. Later that night, when the ship's bell rang, could it be the North when they've been feeling? Wind in the wires made a telltale sound, and the wave broke over the railing. And every man knew, as the captain did too, 'twas a witch of November come stealing. The dawn came late, and the breakfast had to wait, when the gales of November came smashing. When afternoon came, it was freezing rain in the face of a hurricane west wind. When supper time came, the old cook came on deck, saying, "Fellas, it's too rough to feed ya." At 7 p.m. the main hatchway caved in. He said, "Fellas, it's been good to know ya." The captain wired in, he had water coming in, and the midshipman crew was in peril. But later that night, when his lights went out of sight, came the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Lake Huron rolls, it purely sings in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams, the islands and bays of sportsmen. Farther below Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. The iron boats go, as the mariners all know, with the gales of November, remember. In a musty old hall in Detroit they prayed, in the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa down at the big lake they call Gitche Gumee. Superior, they said, never gives up for dead when the gales of November come early.